Hello everyone, I welcome you all in the course of High Voltage Engineering. In the last lecture we have seen the application of High Voltage Engineering in various fields. Also we have seen the historical development of power system all across the world. So without making any delay, we will start today's session and we will see the overview of Indian high voltage power system. So before starting the course of high voltage engineering, we should know what are the usage of high voltage in various sectors. And the main use as an electrical engineer, we will see in the power system for this subject. So the content of this session is we will just see what is the status of power system, Indian power system right now, and we will see the overview of power generation, what are the key milestone of power transmission system and distribution system. So we all know that power system consists of three parts, that is generation, transmission and distribution. So generation, we will see the generation milestone and we will see the transmission milestone and what is the status of distribution at the load end. So India is the world third largest power producer and third largest consumer of power also. So as per the CEA report, that Central Electricity Authority, if we have to know the power status of India, we should visit that two, three websites. That is very important. That is Central Electricity Authority website, that POSOCO website, and Ministry of Power. Obviously, this all power industry is monitored by the Ministry of the Power. Ministry of Power. So as per the CEA report, central sector, that total installed capacity of the central sector is approximately 93 gigawatt, and it is saving the 25% of the total installed capacity. And the state sector, in state sector, this is 103 gigawatt, which contributes approximately 28% of the total installed capacity. And private sector consists of 173 gigawatt, which is sharing 46.8% of the total installed capacity. So total installed capacity, if you will see, this is 370 gigawatt as on 31st March 2020. So if you will see that this increment of approximately increment in the last 20 years. So these are the gradual increment in state, private as well as in central sector. So we can see this is from 2000 to 2019. So last 20 years, these are the progress, year by year progress we can able to see. If you will see that state megawatt installed capacity progress, we can able to see. So in 2000 to 2001, it was 63 gigawatt, and it reached to 105 gigawatt in end of 2019. And if you will see the central sector, it consists of 27 to 28 gigawatt at the beginning of 2000, and in the 2019, 31st March 2019, this is increased up to 865.97 megawatt. So from 27 gigawatt to 86 gigawatt, it has been increased. And if you will see the private sector, private sector that 9 gigawatt from 2000, it is reached up to 164 gigawatt by the end of 2019. So after coming the Electricity Act 2003, that this private producer, they have increased very fastly increased, and it reached up to the maximum. So this is the power sector growth of all India. If you will see that contribution from the that fuel based contribution, what is the fuel based? So if you will see the thermal generation contributes total 62.8% of the power, which consists of 230 gigawatt of the power is generated from thermal power plant. So thermal power plant consists of that coal based thermal power plant, lignite coal based thermal power plant, and gas based thermal power plant, diesel based thermal power plant. So maximum contribution is from the coal based thermal power plant, that is 54%, and total, if you will see the total that power production from the thermal power plant is 62 to 63%. So highest contribution from the thermal, and then hydro from the hydro we can able to see that 45 gigawatt of power is generated, and it contributes 12.4%, and nuclear is approximately 2%, and from the renewable energy sources it is increasing year by year, and till 31st March 2020 it is increased up to 23.5%. So renewable energy sources consist of wind, that wind power, wind energy, and solar power, small hydro project, biomass, etc. We will see in the in detail in the coming slide. So by the end of 31st March, if we will see what is the percentage of the power generation from the particular plant, that coal based plant, thermal power plant, the generation is approximately 56.36%, and this is the last year data, and hydro consists of 12.75, and renewable energy sources is 21.8, nuclear approximately 1.9%, and diesel 0.18%, gas 7%. So these is coal based, gas based, diesel based, these all comes into thermal power generation, and rest is hydro power plant and renewable energy and nuclear energy power production. So we can see that most of the power is generated from the thermal power plant. If you will see the last that 15-year record, that from 25-year record, 1995 to 2019. So this is the scenario of increasing the specific generation. So hydro, this is the hydro generation, coal based generation, and this is the gas based generation. So overall, or if you will see all type, if you will include all, so this is the graph of all generation, which is increased year by year. Installed capacity growth status, that we can see that at the time of independency it was only 1362 megawatt, and just year by year or decade by decade it has increased, and on 31st March 2019 it is reached up to 356 gigawatt, that installed capacity, and by the end of 31st March 2020 it has been already reached up to 370 gigawatt. Next, we will see that in the generation system, what are the key milestones of Indian power system? How we have achieved from this 1362 megawatt to 370 gigawatt power. So the major contributor of the generation stations are NTPC, NHPC, and NPCIL. This is the central sector power production. So NTPC Limited is a Indian public sector undertaking, was founded by Government of India in 1975. Both NTPC as well as NHPC, NHPC was founded by Government of India in 1975, and NPCIL, that Nuclear Power Corporation of India, was founded in 1987. So these three are the main key milestone which produces power in the Indian power system. So we will see just NTPC group, that this NTPC, how much power is generating, how much stations are there. So present installed capacity of NTPC group is 62 gigawatt. So including, it includes 11 gigawatt through JV subsidiaries and joint venture subsidiaries comprising 45 NTPC stations. So in NTPC station, that 45 NTPC station, that is 24 coal based stations, 7 gas based stations is there, 1 hydro stations, 1 small hydro, 11 solar PV, and 1 wind based stations is there. And in 25 it is a joint ventures. So 9 coal based, 4 gas based, 9 hydro and 2 wind and 1 solar PV stations is there under NTPC. So thermal power plant, this is the basic block diagram of thermal power plant. In thermal power plant, we can able to see there are, this is categorized in basically 4 categories. This is the coal handling plant, and this is the water handling plant, this is the gas that handling plant, and this is the that power producer section. So here coal is coming and pulverized in the machine, and then it is given to the boiler, and here this coal will be burned, and the ash will be handled through ash handling plant. And here that water coming from here through feed water, and this water will be boiled here, and again it will come in the form of flue gases and super heater. And this water, that water comes through economizer to the boiler, and after making the steam, which is going to the super heater to super heat the steam, because it is necessary if there will be any water content, that turbine blades will be, or that corrosion will be there in the blades of the turbine. So it should be superheated, and through the valve it is given to the turbine. So valve will that see that how much speed is required. So it will be controlled through the valve. So turbine will be rotated with the steam, and this turbine will be connected to the alternator. So we can change the speed of the alternator with the help of gears. So here that stator will be stationary, and rotor will be rotated through the turbine, and it will, this alternator will produce 3-phase power, and through the step up transformer it will be connected to the transmission system. So this is the overview of thermal power plant operation. So if you will see the progress of coal based thermal power plant, that at the time of independence only 756 megawatt power is produced from the coal based power plant, which reached up to 200 gigawatt by the end of that last financial year, that is 31st March 2019. So this shows the growth of power plant, that thermal power plant, coal-based thermal power plant from before that independency and after independency till now, how much we have achieved in the thermal power plant. So this is the progress of thermal power plant after independency. So gas-based and liquid-based thermal power plant, it was zero after the independency, and see up to 61 that it was zero. There is no production of power from gas and liquid-based fuel, and after that slowly it has even increased, and it is reached up to 249, 337 megawatt. Or we can say 24 to 25 gigawatt power is generated from the gas-based thermal power plant. So this is the status of gas-based thermal power plant. And diesel-based thermal power plant, that at the time of independence it was 98 megawatt, and it has been increased and then further it is decreased. So it is the status now in the last financial year, it is 638. Basically, we are keeping this as a reserved capacity. So all the time we are not using it. So diesel-based thermal power plant, this is the status. So NHPC means hydro. It is the largest organization for hydro power generation. So it is also that have the capability of 7097 megawatt from 24 hydropower stations. Two other projects are ongoing, which has the installed capacity of 2800 megawatt. So this is the basic operational diagram of that hydropower plant. Here water will be stored in the reservoir, and this where we have to make the dam, and from here that from the this tunnel that water will be flown, and this water will come to the this turbine blades through penstock, and this is the surge tank where this excess water will be stored to for safety of this penstock. And here there will be a generator which will be connected through the turbine. So water will be flown to the turbine, and the speed at which turbine will rotate, that speed that rotor of the alternator will be rotated, or we can change that speed also through gear system, or through the that speed of the water from valve. So in this way we are producing the power from the hydro power station. So if you will see the growth of a hydro power plant in the India, so at the time of independency only 508 megawatt power produces from the hydro power plant, and it is increasing that decade by decade, and it is reached up to 45 gigawatt at the end of 31st March 2019. So we have reached up to 45,399 megawatt production of power from hydroelectric power plant. So basin wise, if you will see the growth of power plant, that basically water basin that from the Indus Valley, Ganga River, Central Indian River, West flowing river, East flowing river, and Brahmaputra basin, all India basin. So this is the percentage which is shown here from the various basins which contributes to the power production of India through hydro power plant. So region wise also we can able to see from this graph that northern region, western region, southern region, and eastern and northeast region. So how much power generation capacity is there region wise. So here we can able to see this is the capacity developed and under operation, capacity under construction. So this is both addition of these two capacity developed and under consideration construction and capacity yet to be developed. So this is the planning to be developed in the northern region. So this is already developed in the western region, and this is under construction. And in addition to this, this is the total capacity, and this is also yet to be developed. So in this way, we can able to see the region-wise power development of hydropower plant. Next is that nuclear power plant. So nuclear power plant NPCIL, that also a public sector enterprise is, and it is under the control of Department of Atomic Energy, Government of India. So here that main that principle of generation is that that neutron will be that heated to the this nucleus, and there will be production of energy from here. So we will see here that NPCIL total installed capacity is 680 megawatt. So here in this generating station, nuclear energy is converted to the electrical energy. So we have seen that in nuclear power station also, that here this diagram, that heavy element such as uranium U-35 or thorium are subjected to the nuclear fissure in subject in a special apparatus known as reactor. So this is the reactor where this phenomena that neutron and neutron will be bombarded to the uranium, and there will be production of other two neutron and lighter element, and energy will be this energy that heat energy released will be used to the to convert water to the steam. So this conversion will take place here. So this is similar to the thermal power plant, but here that fuel will be used, that is the uranium. So nuclear reaction will take place, and that neutron will be bombarded to the uranium, and further this is the process of nuclear reaction, and energy will be produced. This energy will be used to that boil the water, and it will form the steam, and through heat exchanger that steam will be passed to the turbine. So through the pressure of this steam, the turbine blade will be rotating, and this will be coupled with the alternator either directly or through the gear system, so to required to achieve the required speed. So here that after rotation of the rotor, that electrical energy will be produced. So this is the conversion of energy, that nuclear energy to electrical energy, how it takes place. So if you will see the nuclear power plant growth, so in the last 4-5 years it is there is no growth, and it is still 76780 megawatt. And earlier also at the time of independency up to that 31st March 1969, there was no that nuclear power production. But in next 5-year plan, that they have that opened nuclear power plant. So that 640 megawatt of power is generated, and now it is reached up to 6780 megawatt. So this is the nuclear power plant growth from independency to till now. Next is the renewable energy at a glance of India, that renewable energy, how much it is contributing. So in renewable energy, I will make one separate session for the renewable energy. But for the time being, renewable energy is about 23% contribution is there of the total installed capacity. So wind power, we can able to see it is 35,000 megawatt. So accordingly, this is the solar power. This is the rooftop solar power. So this is total solar power is approximately 25,000 megawatt. power is there. So in total capacity, if you will see, this is 78,316 megawatt that grid interactive power connectivity is there from the renewable energy sources. So this is the renewable energy growth of last 12 years. So we can able to see that solar based power and that wind based biomass and solar. So these are the status of growth. So wind is the maximum, and after that solar is there. So this is the growth of last 12 years in the renewable energy. So till now we have seen that about generation of power, what are the power status, power generation status of India, and contribution of NTPC, NHPC, and that NPCIL in the generation of power. Now we will see the key milestone of Indian power transmission system after the independency. So milestone of Indian power transmission system, that in 1948, that Electricity Act 1948, this was the key milestone after independency. So this act came into the existence just after the independency, and the act provided for establishment of CEA, Central Electricity Authority, and the State Electricity Board. So this act clarifies the formation of State Electricity Board and Central Electricity Authority. And after this, that in the next decade, 1950 to 60, there was a growth of state grids and introduction of 220 kV voltage level is there in this decade. And in 1964, constitution of regional electricity board. So this was also a key major keystones, that formation of regional electricity board for integrated operation of grid at regional level in 1964. Then in the next approximately 10 years, that 65 to 73, interconnections of state grid to form a regional grid system. So they have done in this region. So in 1977, that introduction of 400 kV voltage level in India. So in India, 1977, that 400 kV voltage level, transmission voltage level is introduced. And in 1989, that development of HVDC back-to-back system that introduced in India. And in that decade, 80 to 88, that growth of regional grid system as associated transmission system with central sector generation took place. And by the end of 1990, there was introduction of HVDC bipole line, which makes HVDC more economical for longer power, longer distance of power transmission, and for bulk power transmission. And in 1992, the eastern region and the northeastern region were synchronously interconnected through the Bhilpara Salakati 220 kV DC transmission line. 220 kV transmission line. So in 1999, transmission planning reoriented towards all India system, and in 2000, just 20 years ago, introduction of 765 kV transmission line. But it was originally initially that it was charged at 400 kV, later on it is charged at 765 kV. So 765 kV that power transfer capability is much higher than 220 kV and 400 kV transmission line. And this is the one of the major milestone in Indian power transmission system, that introduction of 765 kV transmission line. And the main that key milestone is in 2003, that this is the act, Electricity Act 2003. So here that availability based tariff with real time settlement mechanism implemented in all the five electrical region, creating the basic infrastructure for the operation of electricity market. And then western region was interconnected to eastern region, northeast region. System synchronously connected through 400 kV Rourkela Raipur BC line, and thus the central India system consisting of eastern, northeast region, western dam in a operation bulk inter-regional HVDC transmission system. So this was for the power transfer of 2000 megawatt from Talcher to Kolar HVDC link. So these are the key milestone, three key milestone in 2003. Then in 2000, open access in transmission is approved by the Ministry of Power. And in 2006, that synchronous interconnection took place of the these regions. And in 2007, that northern region also synchronously interconnected with the western region through Agra-Gwalior 765 kV line, operated at 400 kV level, and 765 kV operation of CPAC substation and 765 kV operation of transmission line. So these are the major milestone in 2007. Then 2010, notification of POSCO as a separate entity for operation of RLDC Regional Load Dispatch Center and National Load Dispatch Center come into the picture. That is the key milestone in 2010. And in 2011, that implementation of point of connection based method for sharing transmission charges and losses all across the country took place. And in 2014, the southern grid synchronously connected with rest of all India grid in December 2014 through 765 kV, that Raichur Solapur line. And then in 2016, the northeast region directly connected with northern region, the longest 6000 megawatt HVDC 800 plus minus 800 kV bipolar line from Vishwanath Jirali in northeast region to Agra in northern region for disposal of power from northeast region to northern and western region. In 2017, and that 765 kV Nizamabad Hyderabad line commissioned in July 17, and in also in the same time, that here in the Kurukshetra 800 kV Champa Kurukshetra HVDC bipolar, this is also a bipolar, but at the only unipolar is operated in 2017. So Champa Kurukshetra HVDC bipolar commissioned in September 17. And also at the same time, 800 kV Alipur Dwar Agra HVDC bipolar commissioned in September 17. So this line is carrying 6000 megawatt of power in both the pole, and in one pole this is carrying 3000 megawatt of power by single HVDC line. 2018, 765 Jabalpur 765 kV Jabalpur Orai Aligarh system commissioned in March 18, and a guideline for import export of electricity issued in December 2018. So these are the key milestone in the power transmission system. Then this is the status of growth of high voltage and extra high voltage transmission line all across the country after independency. So we can able to see that at the, just after the independency, only 6430 circuit kilometer that high voltage lines is there, and which is reached now that 681,611 circuit kilometer high voltage and extra high voltage transmission line. So this shows the growth of high voltage and extra high voltage transmission line all across the country after independency to till now. So approximately this is the record of 70 years which is given by at the Central Electricity Authority by the Central Electricity Authority report. And this is the status of high voltage transmission line that below 66 kV that at the time of independency it was 16,808 circuit kilometer, and it is reached to 117,552.41 circuit kilometer at the end of 31st March 2019. So this is the growth of high voltage lines up to 66 kV. So till now we have seen the generation status of Indian power system, transmission status of Indian power system. Now we will see the status of power distribution system. So distribution system, we all know that it is the most important link to connect that power generation coming from the transmission to the consumer end. So so many government of India projects is there in the distribution side also to strengthen the sub transmission and distribution network in urban areas, also metering of distribution transformer feeders consumers in urban areas. So smart metering scheme is also there, and government have huge expenditure in this metering system and is extending the sub transmission distribution network in urban areas. IT enabled enabled distribution sector and strengthening of distribution network to make it a smart distribution system. So distribution system, if you will see, there are as per the nature of the current, there are two types of distribution system: DC distribution system and AC distribution system. And as per the construction, we can able to see that overhead distribution system is there, and there will be underground distribution system. So as per the scheme, that there are three types of scheme: that radial system is there, and one is the ring main system, and another is the interconnected system. Then if you will see the category of loads which is there in the Indian power system, the load is categorized in this major five areas, that is all the industry runs on the power. So industrial load is there, commercial load is there, domestic in the every home there is that power apparatus, that starting from the bulb to the fridge, refrigerator, TV, washing machine, everything in today's life is working on the power. So that domestic load is there. Traction, the transportation, that all the train and metro, it is also working on the electrical power. So every sector we can able to see nowadays it is working on the electrical power only. That electric industrial almost all industry need power for production. That commercial sector, domestic sector, traction and other loads is also there. So these are the five category of the loads which is there in the power system. So if you will see that category wise, what is the percentage of the consumption, that if you will see that industrial sector consumption is 41% approximately of the total power of India. That industrial sector that takes 41%, and commercial is 8%, 8 to 9% is taken by the commercial sector, and domestic sector is approximately 25% load is there in the domestic sector. And traction, that train, metro, everything, that traction is 1.5% of the total load. And the agriculture sector also that power is 17.69% is used, and miscellaneous is 6.63%. So this is the bar chart of load status of electricity consumptions in all sectors. If you will see the domestic load share, that how it has increased from the independence, at the time of independence only 423 gigawatt hour that domestic load was there, and it is increased up to 296219 gigawatt hour at end of 2018-19 financial year. So this is the growth of commercial load connected to the Indian power system. So just after the independence, it was only 178 gigawatt hour, and it is reached up to 98,622 gigawatt hour. So this is the increment of last 70 years, approximately last 70 years. So how it is increased, this is the growth of commercial load in Indian power system. So then come to the industry. Industry at after independence, the less amount of industry is there, that only 2960 gigawatt hour that electricity consumption was there in the industrial field, which reached up to 4,92,361 gigawatt hour at the end of 2018-19 financial year. So this is the status of growth of industrial load on the Indian power system. This is the status of traction load. So traction load just after the independence, it was 277 gigawatt hour, and it reached up to 18,188 gigawatt hour in 18-19 financial year. So this is the status of agriculture load growth. So at the time of independence, it was only 125 gigawatt hour, which reached up to 211,609. So this is the, shows the growth of agriculture. So we have seen the approximately all category of loads are increased. How much just after the independence? So last 70 years record is given by the Central Electricity Authority report. So this is the status of mixed load growth. So mix is also increased from 219 gigawatt hour to 79,309 gigawatt hour. So if you will see that what is the status of rural electrification growth in India, so how many number of villages has been electrified just after the independence. So at the time of just after the independence, no villages have the power. So it has zero. So and at the end of last to last financial year, that is 31st March 2019, that 5,97,464 number of villages has been electrified under rural electricity development. Per capita consumption of electricity shows the growth of any country. So it is also increased from 16 to 1,181 kilowatt hour. But still, it is very less if we will see compare, if we will compare with the other country, the per capita electricity comparison. So it is the minimum compared to Canada, USA, Australia, Japan, France, Germany, Korea, UK, Russia, Italy. So if you will compare from the other country, and average of the world is more than 2000 kilowatt hour, but in India it is approximately under that 1000 only kilowatt hour is there, that per capita electricity consumption in 2016. So it is increasing. It shows the growth of industry, that per capita electricity consumption and usage of that devices by the electrical devices by the that common man or every that people of the India. If you see the status of transmission and distribution losses in India, that from the independence, that losses, this is a major concern where we have to work more, that how can these losses can be reduced. So at the time of independence, this losses percentage was approximately 15% of the power is lost in the transmission and distribution side. Means say for example that if they are sending the power 100% power, only 85% power is reached up to the distribution end. So that it has been increased year by year, decade by decade, and it was maximum in the 2000, okay, 33.98. So this was the transmission and distribution losses, and it includes that power theft also. Okay, so then after the Electricity Act 2003, that it has been reduced that up to 21%. So now also it is approximately 20 to 21% transmission and distribution losses are there in India. If you will compare with the other countries, that world is approximately 9% losses are there in 2015-16, but in India it is the highest, 21-22, and other countries are also there that in which losses are more that compared to the average world losses, that is Brazil, Russia, Canada, and South Africa, and these are the countries where losses are more. So this is the forecast of peak load demand that from 2006 to 2019. So 15 years load forecast is there, and how it has been met, how much it has been met. So it is also there. So like in 2006, that forecast in peak load demand was forecasted 104,867 that megawatt, and actual was 100 gigawatt only. So these are the scenario of forecast and actual. So this is at the end of 2018-19. So forecasted was 188 gigawatt, but in actual it was only 177. So this is for the planning of power production, transmission and distribution end. So this is the planning of power system to meet the load demand of India. So this is the forecast, similarly forecast the peak energy demand of last 15 years. So with this we have seen that generation status, power generation status of India, power distribution status, power transmission status, the key milestone of Indian power system just after the independency, and till now how much growth is there in all the sector. So these are the four acts which came into the picture just this is the act before the independence in 1910 Electricity Act, and just after the independence these three are the Electricity Act which regulates the electricity that commission, that all state electricity regulatory commission, and they are fulfilling the need of power in all the sectors. So with this we come to the end of this presentation. So we have seen all the generation, transmission and distribution status of country of the last 70 years. So these are the key references I suggest to the student they should visit to update their knowledge, at least if they are reading electrical engineering. So they should know where is the use of electricity, what is the status of high voltage engineering, what is the application of high voltage engineering, this they should know. So student, I advise to the student to visit Ministry of Power and see the generation, transmission, distribution report, update their knowledge at in this semester, and that central electricity authority to see the reports. I have shown the various data, so they can update every time with the CEA authority, CEA website, and national power portal. In national power portal, they are giving daily production also. So how much power is generated yesterday, we can able to see in the national power portal. And MNRE website, that growth of that renewable energy, we can able to see, and we can see the various reports given by the ministry in this website. Also that major producer of power, that is NTPC, NHPC, NPCIL. So these are 7 to 8 websites that students should visit to understand the current status of the power system. So where in the generation also and in the transmission and distribution we are using high voltage. So all the high voltage power approaches must be tested. So insulation and testing we will see in detail in the in this course of high voltage engineering. Thank you. For any query, students may email me on this email ID argupta@niitkkr.ac.in. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.